Welcome to Culture Crash, where we examine what's new and old in entertainment. How do you pass the time on your commutes? Do you tune in to the radio, put on a podcast? Maybe you listen to an audiobook. Audiobooks are undergoing a bit of a renaissance right now, and their newfound portability is a main reason why. For a long time, listening to an audiobook meant shelling out big bucks or sitting on a library waitlist to obtain a huge, unruly set of tapes or discs. You'd put them in one after another and listen to books on tape for long car rides or an arduous flight. But now, audiobooks can be the most convenient way to read, or at least consume, a book. Gone are those days of cassette after cassette. Now audiobooks can be purchased directly on your phone, or most likely borrowed for free through your library subscription via a web app like Overdrive. And once you've gotten your audiobook, you can save it right to your phone and click play whenever it's convenient. Personally, I love driving to the sounds of a good book and experiencing an old favorite through new eyes, or being able to easily tear through a good thriller. One big reason in the minds of many an audiobook listener is which works best for them. Are they listeners who want to get the biggest bang for their buck on a mammoth of a book, or to zip through some shorter books on their commute? For example, you can really invest weeks worth of commutes on nearly 48 hours of listening to Stephen King's The Stand, or 21 hours of Herman Melville's Moby Dick. Or you can pick up some shorter reads, like Trevor Noah's Born a Crime, which clocks in at just under 9 hours and can easily be finished in just 1 week's worth of commuting time. Much like reading a real book, I find that different seasons and moods predispose me to different audiobooks. Do I want a light, funny memoir like Amy Poehler's, or a dark, scary horror novel? It always just depends. Regardless of your inclination, it might be worth it to try listening to an audiobook when riding the train or driving in heavy traffic. It might just make your commutes feel more productive. And if you're looking for a recommendation to get you started, Bryan Cranston's narration of Tim O'Brien's Vietnam War classic, The Things They Carried, is one of my favorites. You can visit our site, viewpointsonline.net, for resources on how to check if your library offers free audiobooks to subscribers. I'm Evan Rook.